It's over, Anakin! I have the high ground!
You underestimate my power!
Don't try it! One. It was said that you would destroy this Sith, not join them! Bring balance to the Force, not leave it in darkness!
Hey guys, it's Ramzilla here. So, I'm back with another Dark War video. I think the meme has evolved one more time from Wallet War, to Dead War, to, I forgot what was that other one, now it's Greed War. It pains me, honestly, because I've spent quite a bit of money in this game, maybe not as much as others, but I think I'm done with this game. Is it the lollicops? Are they here to get me? But, I think I'm done with this game, honestly. The point of the game, or at least to me, how I feel, is to get character cards, right? If you can't get character cards, and you know, you're stuck with the same characters and whatnot. You don't need them. People strive in this game without SSRs and whatnot, but they're still really nice to have, you know? And if you can't get them, it feels pretty bad because you don't know when they're gonna come back around. Like, for example, I don't know, I have him at 4 stars, and I need one more to get him at 5 stars. And he hasn't come back around in time limit drop for a long, long time. The past 2 SSRs we've gotten, Wounded Kaneki was in that fucking spin piece of shit thing where people spend from 350 and then you have people that spend 70,000 and got shafted big time, like elephant dick, no reach around. And you have people like me that I don't pay for much, for many diamonds. Hold that thought. So, as I was saying, I don't buy that many diamonds as other people, and it's for that reason. I have a lot of other expenses. Maybe if I was a big YouTuber and earned millions in ad revenue, I could spend that much money on this game and showcase more stuff for you guys, but I can't. So I can't. The game isn't like before when it first started, so, it takes ages for me to save up 7,500 diamonds to get a guaranteed SSR. This is a 2 million download celebration event. Get a free, keyword free, SSR Kakuja Kaneki. There is a chance of getting SSR Kakuja Kaneki from the VIP card draw, VIP card draw, wait, VIP VAR draw unlocks. VIP VAR draw unclocks for players of VIP 6 or above during that event. Come on, GameZomba. So we're gonna get into this event and I'll show you. So as I was saying, there's people that can strive in this game without SSRs. I personally just like collecting them and having them. That's just a personal choice, but you know, if more are gonna come out and I won't be able to get them, and it's just, I don't know. it feels bad. Maybe it's just me. Because I can't explain it, but alright. So, I have 12 shards out of 80. But, VIP card draw event. There is a chance of getting SSR Kakuja Kaneki from the VIP card draw. VIP VAR draw unclocks for players of VIP 6 or above during the event. Targeted reward. During the event period, each quest completed means a goal achieved. Complete the required number of quests to get the prize of the ultimate goal. Festival goals. During the event period, you can receive rewards by completing event goals. Pop up faster. So he's free, but you have to top up. During the event period, if you top up every day, as required, you will receive the reward for topping up continuously. Login reward. During the event period, you can log in every day to claim rewards. Happy collection. There's a chance of getting item shards and dungeon drops, which can be used to redeem relevant rewards. So these are the goals. Clear hard stages. You have to use a ton of stamina for these, because every 5 stamina clear wastes 50 stamina, so you know, clear 315 diamonds consumed. So for each one of these, you get 1 shard. So diamonds consumed. I've consumed all my diamonds as always, but that's a goal. So if you consume these, then you need to top up 20,000 diamonds. I mean, fuck. Gold consumed. You can consume up to 7 million. So these are, let's see. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 shards here. Buy stamina. You need diamonds to buy stamina. You need stamina to do that. And I guess you can do the challenge arena. So he's free. But if you top up, you get these VIP. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. So you end up getting a free draw in 7 days if you top up 800 diamonds daily. So, let's see. If you top up 800 diamonds, so you're spending $20 in 7 days, that's $140 that you're paying. Fuck. $140 that you're paying for this Kanagi, I guess you could say. And that's not even guaranteed, I guess. That's just to do the VIP draw. And it's just like, come on, why? So, as a free-to-play player, this just isn't working out. Day one. So only in the first day you end up getting two tickets. And then Happy Collection, where you look for these and you can get these. So, I don't know. To be honest, this is just another cash grab. 2 million downloads and get a free keyword. As is hard. When he's not really free, you actually do end up paying for him, and that feels bad. The game wasn't like this when it first came out. I don't know what happened. It probably saw the potential of everyone paying and so on and so forth to get their characters. And it hurts that this game has come to this. As a really big fan of Tokyo Ghoul and not being able to get certain characters, it feels bad. And for example, if you actually want to strive or something, you do need certain characters upgraded all the way and whatnot. And you know, Game Samba isn't a really good developer. For example, they released the spin event last week. I'm on a Discord server and some guy spent, let's say, 2,000 diamonds at max. Salud! And he got Winded Kaneki to 4 stars, I think. I spent 7,800 diamonds, 7,800 diamonds on the refresh to try and get him, and I got shafted hard. You don't even know. Like, I've never been so shafted in my life. And it's like, how is that possible? On top of that, I mean, they nerfed him because his damage was fucking insane. Like, you. Sweet Korean Jesus, bless thy soul. And I don't understand. understand, like, how Game Samba, they're working, how do they have such a big title, or titles, because they're also working on an Attack on Titan game. And I have a feeling that's why, because why this game doesn't get as much attention, why the update took so long, because they're working on the Attack on Titan game. And obviously, you know, you can only do so much, and if they're not a very big developer where they can have two teams working on two things at once, things are gonna get fucked up like this, where your event is gonna say VIP Bard draw on clocks, where update is gonna take 3 months, where your PvP on day one update is not even gonna work, where there's a lot of lag on your PvP, where you get paired up with people on a much higher rank than you in PvP, where you have 500,000 RC and you get paired with someone that has 2 million RC level, where you're gonna do stupid shit like this, where you get a free SSR but he's not really free. And so it's like, where you have a gem system that makes no fucking sense, where you have to look for gems and gems, and it's like, I don't know who came up with this fucking idea. There's so many things where the fame system, I'll give it, it was actually a pretty good idea. It increases, it makes some things easier to get, makes you being, you're able to progress in some areas. Like, I went from stage 60, I think, last time, to stage 81 now in Cochlea. So there are some things that did work in this update, but most of them are shit, honestly. And I don't know why or how Funimation, how Game Samba got hired to work on such big titles. Tokyo Ghoul is a really big title. I have a feeling this is what the Attack on Titan game, the same thing is gonna happen. It's gonna come out, and then everything is gonna be really good for free-to-play players in the beginning, and then the first major update is gonna come, and we're gonna get, it's gonna turn pay-to-win, we're gonna get shafted. And then we're not going to get an update again for who knows how long. 3 months maybe. Just like with Tokyo Ghoul. And it's going to be more pay to win. Things are not going to work. And that worries me because Attack on Titan is also a really big franchise. So, does Funimation not keep up with, you know, their titles? That, like, for example, in this case, are they not keeping up with Tokyo Ghoul Dark War? Are they in some sort of development with the Attack on Titan? Because their name is plastered on this. This piece of shit, greedy mobile app, their name is plastered on this. And I play a lot of other gacha games. I play Dragon Ball Legends, I play Pacific Rim, I play Tokyo Ghoul Reinvoke, I play Tokyo Ghoul War Age. I know what you're probably thinking, how are you going to complain about Dragon Ball when you play War Age and it's extremely pay to win? Yes, it is extremely pay to win. But the thing is that in that game you can strive the same with this, I guess, without needing SSS characters, you know. But that's a whole different story. For example, that game offers way more content than Dark War. Oh yeah, because level 81, but I did that one instead. I'm not gonna do that right now. But I play a lot of other gacha games, and for example, Reinvoke. They have banners, but you gotta know which banners to pull on. You don't pull on every banner. So, for example, they had the Serpent banner with Nishiki, and he's not that good a character, so Trap banner to not pull. They have a Hinami banner a while back to not pull. So wait for Fest banners on Reinvoke, and you know, you'll be good. Gives me a chance to save up. So you just gotta know which banners to pull and which banners to not pull on. Unlike this game, where they had, let's say, a time limit draw every week, where you had a chance to get, I don't know. Where are you? There we go. Where you had a chance, no, what are you doing? Where you had a chance to get Yamori, you had a chance to get Yamori. Noro, Anima Ixa, Gourmet. For example, with Kuroiwa Arata, you have to pay $75 to get him. With Wounded Kaneki, it was that stupid spin piece of shit thing where... Man, that makes me so mad. It took me so long to save up so many diamonds, and other people were saying, oh, you need between 2,000 to 3,000 diamonds to get... Yeah, no, no. Some guy spent 70,000 and got shafted. I spent 7,800 and got shafted. Kaneki, half Kakuja, you need to top up. You need to do all these things, like... I'm probably gonna be doing the events for the week. Maybe, I don't know yet. I'm honestly considering quitting this game forever and just be done with it until they fix their issues, if this game ever gets fixed. But I don't know. I don't know what to do at this point, honestly. Should I even keep on going? Should I not keep up going? Because the whole point of my channel and starting this Dark Horse series is to showcase the game. That's why I started, because not a lot of people were playing this game. I wanted to help people with this game. So I started it. That's the reason why I started this channel. Not channel. why I started this game series. And to showcase characters that maybe you couldn't get, but I could. But at this rate, there's not going to be any characters left for me to showcase, because I'm not going to have them. So, I don't know. Let's say Owl comes around after this. I'm not going to have any diamonds for him. Let's say Kankanaki comes around, and I'm not going to have any diamonds for him. So, I don't know, to be honest. The first character they released in the time limit draw was Ayatun. He sucks so much. You don't even know. He's really bad. But they released him. And it seems like Game Samba doesn't really care. Like, they're just releasing stuff just to release stuff. I know people have spent so much money on this game, and if I had the money, I probably would too, but if I had a lot of money, I'd probably go to Game Sama headquarters and be like, what the fuck are you guys doing, you know? Try and talk something out with them, kind of like the way Afro has connections with Bandai, do that with Game Sama. But, I don't know, man, that's just my way of thinking. I know you're probably expecting gameplay, but... this is more of a rant on how I'm seriously thinking of quitting this game, because I have a feeling it's only going to get worse from here. And once the Attack on Titan game comes out, if it took them 3 months to release an update for Dark Lord because they're working on the Attack on Titan game, how much long is it going to take before, you know, they're going to release another more stuff for Dark Lord once the Attack on Titan game comes out? How many more screw-ups are we gonna get? Like this, where it says VIP VAR draw on clocks. How many more bad characters are we gonna get where Ayoto mask sucks, but Wounded Kaneki over here is able to do 100 gazillion damage? Where are you? Upon release, like... How much more are we going to take from this, you know? So, that's just kind of my rant. This is my message to Game Samba, I guess you could say. If other YouTubers that are playing this game want to suck Game Samba's dick, want to take Game Samba's dick up their ass, that's fine with that. I'm not going to go that route. I fucking had it. This is just my message to Game Samba. Fix your game. Work on it. Take your time. Tokyo Ghoul is a big property. You want us to play Attack on Titan as well. You can bet your ass I'm going to play it. And I'm going to go ahead and showcase it. And see, you know, how good of a game it is. How pay to win is it. I'm going to let you guys know how it is. And, you know, But on Dark War, it's getting harder and harder and harder to make content. And as a fellow creator, I'll tell you why it's getting harder and harder to make content. I don't want to join PvP and get matched with someone that has so much more RC than me, because you guys are probably going to get bored of that. You guys are probably like, oh, this guy fucking sucks. Nobody wants to be that guy. I can't really show you guys Cochlea, except for this stage, because most of the time I just sweep Cochlea. If I were to make constant updates on Dark War, it would just be doing these missions every day. It would just be me sweeping stages every day. It would maybe me doing story, but you know, they're really short and so on and so forth. So there's not much to do. That's why I'm saying it's a little hard to make content on this game, because there's not much to show. That's why my main purpose of the game was to help people and showcase characters such as these SSRs, but I'm not able to do that. You have creators like, let's say, Lee is chill, and I'm not bashing on him or anything, but and during the time that I stopped making videos on Dark War, he was making videos like the, what do you call them? Let me look them up real quick. The potential of X character, was it? Hold on. The value of NR. So he was making videos like that for certain characters, and I don't know, I don't want to be like that. I don't want to just put out random content like that, because that's not the purpose of this. I mean, let's be honest here, at this point, at how you made it, those characters, even though they are all maxed out, 5 stars, 5 stars, they don't have much value to them. Except maybe Kaneki, because of his life steal, and maybe you would have to increase his fame and see how that goes. But even then, you know, it's ridiculous because you need gold and shards, and it's like, huh. Shards I have a ton of, but that's besides the point. End characters and NR characters don't have much value to them. For example, you have Saito Takizawa that slows people's damage down. But then you also have... Where are you, my good friend? You have Takizawa. You also have Marud, who also slows people's damage down. So, it's like, I don't know, to be honest. I don't want to make that kind of content. It's like the value of N character, the value of NR character, the value of Ariyamori, the value of Ayato Kirishima. Because nobody cares about stuff like that. At least from my point of view, I don't really care about those characters, so it's not going to really matter. Because most people only really care about the SSRs, because they're the most cool looking characters. You have Kaneki Hapakuja, who has great art, look at that. Really cool art. You have the owl. Really cool looking guy over here. You have other characters that people are more interested in than the NRs and Rs and so on and so forth. But, you know, So this is just kind of like my rant on this game. I think I'm done with it. If I don't upload any more Dark World videos, you know why. I had a fun ride with this game. 5 months playing it since it came out in January. February, March, April, May, June, July. 5 months playing this game. It's been a fun ride, to be honest. But I think it's time to say goodbye at this point. There's just nothing. There's just nothing left for me to do in this game. I guess you could say. There's nothing to keep me afloat if they're gonna be doing shit like this, you know? There's nothing left to keep me interested in the game. Yes, I still have other SR characters to level up, like kind of Black Dog. I still have other characters that can increase my RC if I were just to, you know, farm for equipment for these characters, etc. But besides that, there's just no point. At least to me, honestly. And I don't really care about winning or becoming the strongest or getting 2 million RC. I just want to showcase characters for you guys. I want to show you their abilities, show you what they can and can't do, etc. But I can't do that if I can't get them. You know what I mean? So I think for now, I think maybe I'm just going to log into the dailies, go back to what I was doing before the big update. And see how things go. Wait on the Attack on Titan game. But if things don't get better, then I'm just going to say goodbye to Dark War. Even my dogs are saying goodbye to Dark War. Tokyo Ghoul Breed War. Well, guys, this is it on my rant. Let me know what you guys think about the current status of the game. Do you guys still play it? How do you guys feel about it? Do you plan on continuing to playing it? Are you going to spend money on it, etc.? Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe on my channel. I'll see you guys in the next video.